Now, let us understand on values. See, ethics are something, these are the rules and regulation which needs to be followed, and it is necessary, otherwise your business gets failed or you have to close your business. Now, values are something which are imbibed into you when you are living in a civilized society. So, let's understand about values. See, we have this Milton Rockage who says that beliefs, values are those beliefs that guides action and judgment across variety of situations. What you believe, that will guide you in performing or acting in certain manner when certain situation crops up. Okay, so here values are nothing but what people consider good and bad themselves. Okay, when it comes to business, social values define the objectives of a business as well as the manner in which the business would be conducted. So social values are the ones which are derived or which drives the business as such, and the way the business affairs would be conducted are purely based on social values. Okay, entrepreneurs share these values, so they are entrepreneurial values. The social values become entrepreneurial values because they share their values. Now let's understand this. See, you have been given core values out here and you have the action factors. So as we can see here, the person will develop certain core values from the day he is born till he become a grown up. Okay, now this would be because of his active interaction with his parents, environment, people around him. Okay, so the personality factors and action factors get determined because of these interactions. So core values determine the values in a person, and remember, initially the parents and the teachers play the most important role when it comes to imbibing certain values in a person. Now let's start with core values. Now innovation and creativity, this is one kind of core value which we have. So this is, a entrepreneur should have the most must have innovation and creativity. We have already discussed this in detail that why innovation and creativity is necessary. Remember that this is one of the most important value for an entrepreneur. Okay, creativity, as I have been telling you, is nothing but the ability to see new ways of doing things, watching the surroundings and coming up with new ideas, innovative products. Okay, now we have already discussed this, the sachet packets which came in, the tetra packs, you have the electric kettles which are being used nowadays. So these are all creativity or innovation which has come in. Now innovativeness can be seen through actions like facing uncertainty while trying new things, positive attitude during failures. See, it is not necessary that today I start making a product, it will be successful. I would face failure 100 times, maybe more than that. But then I should have an attitude which should not dampen my spirits, and I should be able to overcome those failures. I should demonstrate originality. When I say demonstrate originality, means an entrepreneur should have the capability of doing something in a unique and a original manner, something which no one has done earlier. Should provide critical inputs. Now, independence or ownership. See, a strong and a positive ego will drive. If a person has a very strong and a positive ego drive, then he would be involved in the action plan of all significant entrepreneurial ventures. So having this independence or the value of independence or the value of ownership is necessary. Okay, now this third value is to respect the work. Successful entrepreneurs believe they can achieve anything through hard work. They say they have a respect for work and they believe that whatever are the difficulties, they could be overcome if I keep on working hard. This value provides them a goal direction. They know what is my goal and how it can be achieved. Now, the other value or the last value here is the quest for outstanding performance. An entrepreneur should value outstanding performance. He should always look out for getting 110 out of 100. So whenever he'll perform, he'll say the results should give me 110 out of 100. There has to be speedy growth. We have seen the example of Infosys, wherein how it has grown over the years. and how things have changed for the company. Now I'll give you an example of Apple phone. When Apple phone was launched, they came up with this eco-friendly package and a lightweight 3D dimensional, that is three dimensional images on it. So Steve Jobs was not just interested in getting a new phone into the market. He also ensured that he is demonstrating outstanding performance by ensuring a eco-friendly package which would be well accepted by consumers, and also going in for 3D, that is three-dimensional images on it. So outstanding performance is something that an entrepreneur should have. He should always be one step ahead of other resources or employees he has when it comes to outstanding performance.